when you're working up a lace and you want to have this side stitch here go up on a vertical slant, whether it's going to the right or to the left, you have to do two steps to get that to work out. So first of all, whether you found a pattern that you want to do or you just want to make up your own, as always I suggest doing trying up a sample of this just so you can get used to it before you work it into a sweater or whatever else. Now I'm just gonna wing this, as I have with many other things. I'm choosing to do every fifth stitch. And now I want to have, okay, there we go. I didn't really count how many stitches I casted on, but I've got 20 to 17. I didn't even get all the way to 20 over there. But anyways, now, and you'll see as you go, what you need to do is, the eyelet's going to be either to the left or to the right, depending on how you're starting this out. But what I'm going to do is to start out, is I'm just going to take this first needle I selected, and everyone's going to be the same for how many rows I want it to go that way. But I move it to the needle to the left, I take those two stitches off, and move it back to the right. So now here's my empty needle that's going to be the eyelet. Now I don't have to always go. I could, depending on the lace you're working on, you may want to have it maybe crisscross and join each other. So you're going to just take those needles, transfer them over, transfer them back. And that'll give you that nice line of the V knit stitch next to the lace. Now, I'm not going to do this one because it is too far to the left here, so that one is going to be omitted for the time being. And depending on whether you want to do it every row or every other row, I'm going to show you what it looks like for every row. It's going to be a tighter lace is all. So I need to actually push these needles back into the either the forward working position or working position is fine as long as the latches are open. Other machines is going to knit it just right. So now here's the eyelet. The next eyelet, because I want them to go on to the left, the next eyelet's going to be here. But I need to take the stitch to the left of that, move it to the right, and then back to the left. So eyelet, supposedly eyelet, take off, put over to the right, move those back to the left. So I'm going to continue doing this for every row. I'm just going to put the eyelet one over to the left. And when I'm ready to start going to the right, I'll get back to recording again. Oops. Now I'm at the point that I want those eyelets to go on this angle. So again, so I look for the last eyelet. I need the next eyelet to be this one here. But because I want that slanted stitch, I take the second stitch over, put it on that to the left, and then back to the right. Here's the eyelet. So two stitches over. It's the same, but now you're just reversing what you did before. If you want to continue just going up on an angle, you just find the next eyelet. Just keep going to the left is all. It's really up to you You don't have to follow another's pattern. Oh, and it looks like I missed an eyelet. It should have been an eyelet there. But anyways, just continue doing that for as long as you want. Now, where I have 5 eyelets going up, I'm going to have 5 eyelets going the other way. But that first eyelet, the row down, is going to be eyelet 1. So I'm going to have 4 more going angle to the right, and then 4 angling to the left, as much as I need for my design. Here's a sample I already did up with a different yarn. Of course, I didn't continue these over here, but what I did was I put these really close together. I think there was 2 stitches in between the eyelets, and here was 5 stitches in between. It's easier to see up here how that goes. And this was every row, and this was every second row. So you could see how when you do every second row, it's just going to elongate it. But try it out. I'm sure you're going to like to do this kind of lace on something.